Hi, I'm Claire. Welcome back to my channel. For this week's video, I am going to be doing a witch's lair in The Sims 4. So, I wanted to do this kind of like underground hidden home for three witches. I wanted to do three witches. One, because of Hocus Pocus. I've watched that recently, so I just watched the first one. And if you want to leave your comments down below of Hocus Pocus references, go ahead and do that. And second reason why I wanted there to be three witches in this house is because there are three different like houses of spells, I guess. I'm dyslexic and sometimes it's hard for me to find the words I want to use, but there are, in The Sims, there are three different like head spell people. And so there's like three different symbols, and yeah, so maybe each of these Sims is one of those, like, house, I'm saying, just Harry Potter. And so we are in the kitchen currently. This is kind of a smaller kitchen, not really like the biggest, it's kind of a galley style, but it's a pretty simple kitchen. All the clutter decorations is in one corner, so if these three Sims want to cook together, they have plenty of room to do so. And so I did want to use a lot of windows in this layer, I'm calling it, because of the stained glass, and I thought it would be really cool. And since it is like a layer, I did want to have like pockets of different areas for light to come through, so it doesn't really feel like you're in a cave. And so now we're just kind of figuring out a little seating area, and now we are going to be working on the dining room. I wanted to use this big table because I wanted there to be a lot of stuff from the Aroma Magic, and then I also thought it'd be fun to like pretend that like the witches of this house like host dinner parties on the weekends with the other witches and wizards or spellcasters in the area. And so we are just going to kind of be working on this front entryway area and going to be adding a rug in the dining room. I don't know, I was trying to keep this area kind of consistent with the colors. I was also thinking the Sim that lives in the bedroom right next to the dining room kind of picked out all of these colors because it's the same kind of royal dark blue from the dining room in the bedroom. And so now we are just going to be adding a few decorations in to this like front porch area and going in to the first bedroom. So like I said, this is the bedroom where I kind of thought maybe like the head spellcaster would be, since the color is blue and like most of the dining room and the front area is blue. Or maybe she just has more of a picky design style. And so we are just going to be trying to find some pictures. It was really hard because I wanted to go like for this like whimsical spellcaster fantasy, but like I feel like most of these pictures were like modern art. And so we are just going to be adding some lights on the side table and going into the bathroom. So each bedroom does have their own ensuite. This is the only bedroom or bathroom I'm going to be showing, just for simplicity. They're all pretty much the same. Actually, I'm pretty sure this is the only one with a bathtub, but I wanted to make sure to use a shower since I don't really use like the spellcaster items that often. What's the pack called? Realm of Magic for the pack for a second. I couldn't really find a lot of, I don't really use the Realm of Magic pack that often, and so I wanted to go a little crazy in this build. And so now we are in the third bedroom, and this room kind of has like a calming white theme in it. And so I did want this story to be in this room of a maybe girl who is like just graduated from high school, or maybe is in like that high school age, and so she has like makeup next to her mirror and like posters on her walls, and I thought that would be kind of a fun idea. This window next to the dresser does actually go like look out into the back of the courtyard, and I thought that'd be fun to like have more of a bigger spot for light. And so I would imagining this sim to be a little bit of a bookworm, kind of into like most things that the teenagers are into in the game. And so since this is a witch's spellcaster's lair, I wanted to use the poster that, I forgot the name, it's like Harry Puffer, I think. And so now we're just using these posters from the Parenthood pack. I thought that was a fun option for this room because I'm trying to go for like a younger person. And so now we are just going to kind of be finishing up that area, and now we are going to be going into the office space, and this is where you would also enter into the back courtyard. The reason why I have the like door here is so your Sims can like be like taking notes in this like office room, and then their like big potion pot is out in the courtyard for less cleanup if there is something explodes, basically. And so we are just going to be adding a lot of different things, like a computer, and now you can see we're adding a telescope from the werewolf's pack. I just barely got that pack, and so I'm trying to see where things look best. And I did want to also add a few skill items in this room, so I have two guitars and a violin, so maybe these free witches have a acoustic band on the side from doing different witches potions. And so we are just going to be adding just a few more details into this room, this office, and now we are going to be heading in to the back courtyard. So like I said, I wanted this area to be for your Sims to cast their potions, but with less explosions than in the room. So there is like kind of like a not trellis, but there is like kind of like a roofing above this. Just realistically, your Sims won't fall in, but I know your Sims don't really fall in. The area above this is like kind of a forest. I wanted it to kind of like be like a hidden area that you have to like seek if you want to find. And so we are just going to be adding some planter boxes and just trying to figure out what to do with this like middle space. And I do end up adding just kind of like a small little seating area with a table. And so we are just going to be going into the third and final bedroom. This bedroom's kind of more of a darker vibes, and so I wanted this room to also kind of have like a bookworm, but like more of like a collector's in a way. And like the sim with the second bedroom is just like, oh I like this book, but this sim definitely is like, I have a book collection. And so we are just going to be adding some dressers into this room. And I do also add a wand holder into all of the other two brooms. I thought that was a fun detail. I do also add witches' brooms, so your Sims can fly around on their brooms. Again, this is something I don't really use unless I'm building a house purposely using Realm of Magic. And so we are just going to be now in the front courtyard area. Just trying to make it a little bit welcoming, but kind of sparse, just so the Sims are like, oh, it's not like that big of a party spot. It's like in the back. That's where the spell potions are. And I did want to add a fireplace because, like I said, when else am I going to use a fireplace with crystals in it? And so now I'm just trying to find a place for this like fountain to go. Again, I don't really know where I want to use it, but I wanted to use as much Realm of Magic items as I could. And so to kind of keep with like the moon theme in the windows, I added a rug in the office that has like the moon phases. And so now we are just going to get benches by the fireplace and going to be adding a little bit of like a sparring table on this back area so your Sims can practice their magic with each other. I haven't really played with Realm of Magic recently, so I'm pretty sure it's just like to like practice their magic on each other. I do also add a portal to the spellcaster's world, like right next to that, I want to call it a battle station or the practice grounds, and so it's quick access for your Sims to get to the magic realm. But if you want to get rid of that, it's just like kind of down the river in a way. But I wanted a quick access for your Sims, and so we are getting close to the end of the video, so I hope you enjoyed watching. If you want to play in this house, make sure to check the description. Make sure to also follow me on Instagram. I'm green_rose_sims, so make sure to follow me also on the Sims 4 Gallery. I post new videos every single week, so please make sure to hit the subscribe button. Bye!